Kampala la bikali na mwechuka mumutwe.
Music piracy is a matter of growing concern in Uganda's music industry. Some musicians have taken legal actions against those who infringe on their materials. Songwriter and performing artist Nins Henry, popular for the hit song Pola Mpola, is one of the victims of piracy. He says one morning he woke up to news that his music was on the shelves of one of the top shopping malls in Kampala.
I simply walked into a supermarket and found my music compiled, packaged, and even sealed with copyright reserved tags and on sale.
This happened just a fortnight with the official release of the album. At the time of the incident, Henry was finalizing the artwork for the album. The incident implied that a pirate worked ahead of him.
Everyone thinks they can just acquire something as long as it exists, it's there. You understand? Yeah, so I don't know whether it's because of the... I think it's because of the law's dormancy.
Music piracy is the illegal copying or downloading of music without the consent of the recording artist, composer, or recording company releasing the piece of music. Henry thinks he's not the only victim of piracy in Uganda's music industry. He partly blames fellow musicians for staying silent on the matter.
Let me give you an example. I went to a function someday, and I found a guy with a piano playing, entertaining the guests on the function, and playing actually people's music. One of my friends is an artist, and we were together at the function. The guy looked at me and he's like, as they played his song, he's like, "Katyo chimanyi nti nokalo yo guy yasasubula naye ali kuzanya nyimba zange." Naye Henry, ekintu ekyo kiraba oti abantu batuyiikiriza. And I seemed like, I asked him, "Why are you telling me? You even know he's using you and you just there, you're telling me batuyiikiriza."
A while ago, court ordered the Anti-Corruption Coalition Uganda, a charity organization, to pay musician Angela Katatumba 30 million Uganda shillings for using her music in an advert without her permission. Alexander Bagonza, a recording artist popularly known by the stage name Apas, like Henry, is not happy about piracy.
"We put in time and money. You're going to invest in a song, put in money, and someone is selling it at 200 shillings. That is not value for what you created. There's a problem. And for me, in the way I see things, I'm so insulted sometimes when I see things like that happen. But keeping in mind, I have nothing to do about it."
Producer Benon of Muyenga-based production studio Swangs Avenue says the prevalence of music piracy can also be blamed on the musicians themselves.
"It's usually the artist that takes the music around. Even to those people we consider pirates, it's usually the artists that give them the music. Yes, the laws exist, but to tell you the truth, the people that are facilitating or breaking these rules, the number one culprits are the musicians, the artists themselves."
The members of public weighed in on the matter.
"For someone to record their music in a studio, they need money, they use money. And for someone to produce your music, you need to pay them so that it's produced. And even if it's a video, it takes a lot of money, scouting for locations, costume, and putting in extras in your video, it's all money. So it's really not good for someone to use your music without either your permission or paying you.
If you can't value your own piece of art, then other people won't value it."
It does appear that the prevalence of piracy in Uganda is not necessarily due to the absence of a law. Uganda is governed by the Copyright and Neighboring Rights Act 2005 and the Copyright and Neighboring Rights Regulation of 2010. The two acts provide for the protection of literary, scientific, and artistic intellectual works, including music, and provides for related fields. Mbabazi Norman Akiki, a lawyer and president of Intellectual Property Center, is convinced that the existing law is not bad.
The law exists. It's a good law for them. If you are found guilty, that material should be banned. The law goes further to create a criminal aspect against the infringer. Can you really say that's a bad law?
Norman, however, believes piracy is thriving due to political reasons and also because of the nature of Ugandans.
The type of political climate is a bit unfavorable for certain laws to prosper. The nature of Ugandans, our culture of stealing, goes beyond. You want to steal money, you want to steal people's works. We are not creative in the sense of once we see something, we just want to better what we have seen and get away with it.
Music library proprietors, in their defense, don't agree that they are pirates as labeled by musicians. They instead say they play a very important role of promotion.
Studios zigenda zinonya bundi we zili libraries we zili ze zi contactinga nazo ne zibawa music wa for the studios naba shooting a videos we want to put down music and sing like that. All things are about to promote because esawa ya lero mwana kutoro imba ku TV, he has to pay.
Norman, however, says according to the law, there's a clear distinction between promotion and piracy.
You see, there are two things in piracy. That there is one which is, we believe is acceptable, which people call fair use. It's not necessarily piracy, but the law provides for it. That if I am using the work for my own self, for no economic gain, then I am not pirating.
Uganda Performing Rights Society is a body started to protect music from piracy and license users so that rights owners benefit from their creations. The organization believes that piracy is a threat to the industry.
It kills creativity. The musicians don't get what they ought to get. For example, presently, they don't get any money from selling their CDs.
Wasula says the manner things were done in the past is different from what is happening today.
In the past, before the advent of the computer, when we still had compact cassettes, we had over 10 publishers / distributors. This included the Kasiwo Kira, Usimi, X-Zone, XYZ, Fred Mkubiran Company. There were many, about 10. And they would buy the rights to distribute from the musicians at as much as 30 million shillings per album.
It is clear that the prevalence of music piracy in Uganda cannot be fully attributed to one group of people, especially those who burn and sell music along the streets and in town. It is therefore very important that any intervention that seeks to get a lasting solution to the problem targets every stakeholder, and this must involve sensitizing them about the copyright law and how it works. Yeka William and Baguma Frank, Kampala.